So I'm going to talk about key and independent homomorphic PRF with homomorphisms induced variable length input. And this is together with my PhD student, Vipin Sarawat. So let me first explain the problem and previous work. So at Crypto 2013, Dan Bonnet and his co-authors introduced updatable encryption and presented a scheme based on their homomorphic, basically pseudorandom function family. At Crypto 2017, issues were identified with a scheme and definition given by Bonnet and all, were basically discussed, and the new definitions were proposed that better capture the confidentiality and integrity goals. Now, a very important paper was proposed by Lehmann and co-authors at EuroCrypto 2018, which took place this year, that considered post-compromise security for updatable encryption and argued the schemes in 2 and 3, so the previous ones, are not post-compromise secure. So let me explain what the main problems are. So what was actually explained at EuroCrypt in 2018 is basically, first of all, a post-compromise secure updatable encryption scheme was proposed. But the proposal actually assumes the decisional Diffie-Hellman assumption, which we know is not quantum safe. And they also pointed out that the reason why there are problems with Bonnet and all scheme is that they fail short of meeting the ideal security requirements because they never update the nouns. That's a very important statement. Therefore, the main restriction in Bonnet and all scheme is that due to the underlying key homomorphic PRF, it basically, that scheme mandates static inputs, so fixed length input, and that disables any modifications in the nouns. So the solution that we propose is designed, so we use lattice-based approach, an updatable nouns, the PRF family, which in addition to being key homomorphic, also allows updates of the nouns. And so to simplify the problem, we place the following restrictions on the function input. So it must belong to an arbitrary but fixed subset of the domain, and also a fixed number of the input bits do not exhibit homomorphisms. And so the restrictions are tailored according to the settings of the updatable encryption model. But very important is to observe that they do not affect the primary goal. So what we also were able to do is to add more features. And so we were able to add some, what you could call some double homomorphisms, in the sense that we have a homomorphism both on the key and the input X, which we expressed in the formula right here. So you see this formula here expresses this homomorphism where this defines an ontomapping. And so we successfully realized key and homomorphic PRFs with homomorphic induced variable input length. So the question now is what we were actually had to do in order to make this feasible is to introduce these restrictions which I pointed out before. So now the question that we actually did not address is, can you actually remove these restrictions? And if you can remove the restrictions, it might be possible to move towards fully homomorphic encryption, which we know that if you want to make this practical, this is a major open problem. And that's basically the end of the talk. Thank you for your attention.